Hello everyone, my name is Rakesh Kumar and I'm the Principal Product Manager here at Microsoft for Defender Threat Intelligence. And with me, I have Rajuta.
Hi everybody, I'm Rajuta Kapoor. I'm a Senior Program Manager. I work in the Microsoft Sentinel space, which is the SIEM product for Microsoft. And I lead all efforts for threat intelligence in the product.
Okay, so the very first demo I have today for you is the detonation threat intelligence. Let's start with that. So here you can see the Microsoft Defender Threat Intelligence dashboard listed out nicely. This is also the intelligence hub with all the articles. I have two samples here to showcase. The very first one is a URL that's from a phishing campaign. Let's inject that into the TI and see what we get back. As you can see, we clearly marked as a malicious with a rule matching to a phishing campaign. There's a description attached to it. There's also a detonation analysis played that shows you the screenshot when the URL was visited. If you look at the data tab, this is where we have all the dynamic analysis associated with the URL. If you go back to the summary page, you can also see related articles, Intel profile, certificate, any matches that were found. Let's go back to the second scenario where I have a hash. Now you can bring this hash from anywhere that you've been currently working on or investigating on, plug it in into the MDTI and quickly learn more about it. The hash shows a quick summary and the data. The summary shows the rule and description. In this case, you can clearly see the hash that belongs to the Miraya, which is of course a very famous botnet often used to launch DDoS attacks. If you want to learn more about Miraya, you can simply plug in Miraya in the search and quickly learn more about it. We have a number of articles on Miraya. We also have a lot of infrastructure that were linked to it that you can clearly see from scrolling down, such as certificates, hosts, components. The second demo I have for you is the APIs. This is the Microsoft Defender Threat Intelligence dashboard that many of you already know about. This is where you can read articles, get into the deep data sets that MDTI has to offer. And now we're making all this available through the APIs. You can learn more about these APIs through the Graph Threat Intelligence API documentation. You can see all the clearly listed out methods that we are available today, the relationships they have, articles, indicators, hosts, components, cookies, trackers, a number of them that we are providing. Let's drill down further into articles and see what we have available. The article method has the list, get, and the indicator functions. The properties listed out as bodies, created date, etc. You can use these to automate, get any of the indicators out from the articles, or even just do simple queries. Let's go further down on the indicator section and see what are the indicators available to us. Now, you can see clearly from the UI pack that the indicators are host, IPs, domains. You will be able to get all those IOCs back from these articles using these APIs. We also have other APIs like hosts, components, cookies that are available. You can learn more about them through this documentation channel. Now, what we can do about these APIs, you can build logic apps with enriched workflows. You can create workbook for automated huntings. You can also use it for your own automation. In the next few slides, you're going to see how you can utilize the APIs, authenticate, and hard run a basic scenario. Now, if you have an application, let's say an Azure application, how can you authorize the application to use the APIs? Let's take a quick look at that. I'm in the Azure portal here. I'm going to create a simple application and assign the API permissions to it. So let's go to the Azure Active Directory. This is my tenant. I'm scrolling down to the app registration. This is where I'm going to register an application. Let's do those. Register an application, give it a good name. Give it the supported account type. I'm keeping it to a single tenant and registering it. Once the app is registered, it gives me a client ID, object ID, and a tenant ID. We will be needing this later on. Let's keep going and add API permissions to the application. Click Add. And now look at the Microsoft Graph. It's already populated for me, so that's good. I'm adding application permission here. I'm searching for threat, and that lists out threat intelligence in the bottom. Let's pick up threat intelligence and add the threat intelligence permissions to. Now, if you are a tenant admin, you will be auto-provisioned for this, and the status will be turned as granted. But if you are doing this for someone else, or someone else in your tenant is doing this, they will getting the request. The request will actually go through the tenant admin. Now in this scenario, I have the application here added here, but I don't have the access granted. So since I'm the tenant admin, I can grant myself the access. Take a second, and there you go. I have the access. So what this means is now my application has the API permissions to run, authenticate, and do all the automation and workbooks and logic apps that I want to do. The next scenario is pretty simple. This is a postman showing you a basic use case of how you can use the APIs. Let's do the authentication part first. We go to the threat intelligence APIs, the authorization area. Here you can run the authorization code for a single user, or you can do it for at the client level. The auth URL requires the tenant admin. Let's add the scope, which is already there. I'm picking up an account that I need to authenticate with. I did that. Now this is the access token that was generated. Right. So this is the canary graph environment. This is just the internal environment. We're going to have production environment listed out for you folks to try it out. So, all right, so I'm now next running the threat intelligence host API endpoints. I'm using Microsoft.com as an example domain. You can clearly see it returned a body and a response code. The next one is a reputation check on a host. In this case, I'm using the Microsoft Office 365 domain. Let's give it a couple of seconds and it should come back with some results. And there you go. I see a resolving IP address, I see a severity, and I see links. Let's run one more, which is the cookies endpoint. And in this scenario, I'm running Microsoft.com as a host, and I'm finding out all the cookies that are running on Microsoft.com. Let's run that. You can clearly see this a bunch of data that comes back. And that's it. Those were the MDTI API endpoints. Thank you, everyone. That was all from the MDTI front. And now I'm handing over to Rajuta for the Better Together stories with MDTI and the Microsoft Sentinel.
Thank you, Rakesh, and great set of capabilities within MDTI. I'm going to talk a little bit about how MDTI and Microsoft Sentinel work together. As you know, that Sentinel is a SIEM solution that offers a lot of capabilities for TI acquisition, management, operationalization, and dissemination. Within Sentinel, you can acquire TI from various sources, whether it's third-party sources that you have purchased TI from, or even Microsoft Threat Intelligence. Today, I'm going to talk about our first feature, which is the Microsoft Defender Threat Intelligence Data Connector. This data connector essentially offers feeds of TI from MDTI into Sentinel with a click of a button. So if you go to the data connectors gallery within Microsoft Sentinel and search for threat intelligence, you will see various data connectors like the threat intelligence taxi connector, the threat intelligence platforms connector, and the latest addition to it is the Microsoft Defender threat intelligence data connector. If you click on the data connector, you will come into the connector page. And you can here see that what this data connector offers, it offers indicators of compromise from MDTI. These can be IP addresses, emails, domains, file hashes, URL kind of indicators. The only thing you need to enable this connector is a read and write permission in the workspace. It's pretty simple to configure this connector. You just come on the connector page and decide your import indicators parameter. This essentially decides how much back in time do you want to go and pull your indicators from. For example, do you want to pull indicators as old as 1 day, as old as 1 month, as old as 1 year, or maybe everything that's available from MDTI today? I have just selected all available in my test environment, and you just click connect. The moment you click connect, you will see that the data will start flowing in to Microsoft Sentinel. This data is available in various forms. It is available both in the Microsoft Sentinel Threat Intelligence Blade, which gives you a bird's eye view of all your indicators of compromise. It allows you to edit them, filter them, search on them. This data also lands into the Sentinel TI log analytics table so that it can be used for detections in the future or hunting queries, etc. With that being said, I'm going to jump into my second demo, which is around the Microsoft Defender Threat Intelligence Analytic. This analytic rule is a rule that you can enable. It is very, very simple to enable this rule. It's just you go on the analytics blade in the product and just enable your analytics rule. It's literally just the enable disable flag that requires the setup. Apart from that, the logic is pretty simple and is determined by Microsoft. And what this essentially does is it takes various indicators of compromise sitting in Microsoft Defender Threat Intelligence Analytics and match them against your logs, like your Ceph logs or your DNS logs. One thing I do want to point out is that this matching is a smart matching, I would say, because, for example, if we match with your firewall logs as an example, and it's a blocked traffic, sure, it is interesting to know, but we will raise a low severity alert because your firewall has already blocked traffic. Whereas if it was allowed traffic, we would raise a high severity alert. So this rule essentially helps your analysts and your SOC prioritize what they see first thing in the morning when they come and log into the incidents blade of Sentinel. Once we receive a match, we also give the matched indicator, which shows up in the Sentinel TI blade. As you can see here, it shows up with the source as Microsoft Defender Threat Intelligence Analytics and also lands in the log analytics table. The reason we give the matched indicator is to provide additional context around what's the threat type, what's the confidence, when was this indicator created, when is it valid until, for example, etc., which Microsoft can provide and has detected in through its research. With that being said, I'm going to go directly into my last demo, which is around a solution. You looked at a lot of great APIs from Rakesh that he had showcased from MDTI. We do have a solution package called the Microsoft Defender Threat Intelligence Solution Package that shows up in the content hub for Sentinel. And what essentially it does is it provides you a group of playbooks which can be deployed at a click of a button from the content hub. And what these playbooks do are these are very enrichment heavy, enrichment scenario playbooks. So for example, you have an incident that's raised within Microsoft Sentinel, and this incident can be raised anyway, whether it's using the TI data that you've brought into the product, or it can be through behavior analytics or any other kind of analytic tool that you have. If it has any entities inside it, what these playbooks do is they take that entity and reach out to Microsoft Defender Threat Intelligence and see what information does MDTI know about that entity and gives the results back. These results are populated in the incidents of the incident blade, and inside the incident, they show up in the comments section. So as an example, you can look here that I have an incident that got raised, which has an IP as a part of its entities. It's 185.82.2173. What these playbooks do is these reach out to Defender TI and get the reputation information about it. What is it related to? Is it related to a particular threat actor like a Cobalt Strike or Hafnium, etc., or maybe Strontium? And then this this all information is populated back right in the incident page for you. So while your SOC analysts are doing triage, it makes the triage process very, very easy and gives this enriched information all in one view. With that, I think that's all about my demo. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch our demos. We really appreciate your time and hope that you will love our features. Thank you so much.
Bye, everyone.